Hello everyone, this is Rajiv Kohli and welcome back to our channel The Teacher. And in this tutorial we will learn about how to customize the quick access toolbar and the office ribbon in Microsoft Word, Excel and PowerPoint. The method that I am going to describe in this video will apply to all these three applications. So I will show you how to do that in Microsoft PowerPoint, and you can apply the same tricks and techniques in Word and Excel as well. So let's get started, and first let me introduce about the quick access toolbar that you can find here on top of this Microsoft Office ribbon. And if I click on this drop down menu, then you can see the customization options here and the default button that you can add into the quick access toolbar. The commands which have the tick mark in front of them have already been added to the quick access toolbar, and you can add new buttons to the quick access toolbar by just clicking on these commands. Like new create a document command has been added to the toolbar, and that way you can add more command to this toolbar. So you can see here that I have added a few commands already that you find in other tabs. Like we have the send to back, send backward, bring to front, align commands that we can find under the shape format tab. And the shape format tab will only appear if I insert a shape first and then select that shape. Then the shape format will appear, and then I can use the align or bring forward and backward command or any other command from the shape format tab. So what if you need to use these kinds of commands a lot? Then you always have to move to the shape format tab first after selecting the shape. But if you add those commands to the quick access toolbar, then you can easily access those commands with just a single click, and they will be right in this toolbar, so you will not have to click on any other tab to access these commands. So we will learn that how you can add your favorite commands to this quick access toolbar, and how you can create a new tab and add your favorite commands to that tab, so you don't have to move to separate tabs to access your favorite commands. So let's get started, and first of all I will click on the file menu, and then we can click on the options, and here you can find that customize ribbon and quick access toolbar. We are going to discuss both of these options, and you can also access this screen by clicking this customize quick access toolbar drop down button, and here you can click on more commands. So first we will customize the quick access toolbar, and the first option I would like to tell you that you can also move the position of quick access toolbar either above the ribbon or below the ribbon. So currently it is above the ribbon, so if you want to move it down, then you can make a check mark on this option and hit the OK key. Now let's move back to the customization options, and first of all I will reset all the customizations for quick access toolbar and the office ribbon that I did before by using this reset option. And here I click on reset all customization and hit the yes button and then hit OK. And you can see that all the buttons that I had added before now gone, and the quick access toolbar is reset to its default settings by clicking on this option. And the same way we can also reset the ribbon. So as you can see that I have already added a tab here, drawing tools, and I want to reset the office ribbon as well. So after clicking on customize ribbon, you can click on reset, reset all customization, and that will reset all kind of customization from the office ribbon alone. So if you want to clean up everything from the ribbon and the quick access toolbar, then you have to use the reset command from both of these options. Hit the OK key, and now you can see that the drawing tools tab has gone also. So now let's see that how you can add your favorite commands to the quick access toolbar, and how you can create your own new tab and new group like this. Word art styles, accessibility, you can also create your own groups inside your own tab. So if you want to add commands from different tabs of PowerPoint, then you can go to more commands, and here under quick access toolbar you can find this option here, popular commands, and you can see a list of most popular commands of PowerPoint. If you want to add any of these, then you can just click that command and click on add, and that way it will get added to the quick access toolbar. So let's say if you want to add a few commands from the shape format tab, then you can click on this drop down menu and here you can choose that particular tab from which you want to add the commands. So if I scroll down, you can see all types of tabs are displayed here, and we want to add commands from the shape format tab. So I will choose this one, drawing tools shape format tab, and here you can see all types of command that we see under the shape format tab. So let's say if I want to add send backward command, then I can select this one and click on the add button, and that one will bring the send backward drop down menu. So I need the command only, so I will add that one. So I also want to add bring forward to this menu, and here is the bring forward. So let's say if I want to add another command from the home tab, then I can scroll up and here I can choose home tab, and all the commands under the home tab are listed here. And let's say I use format painter a lot, so I would like to add this command as a button in quick access toolbar, so I may access this command just with a single click. Now as I will hit the OK key, you will see all these new buttons that we have added here in the quick access toolbar. So let's say we have a shape here and we copy and paste this one, and from the shape format let's say I change the color, and we also add another shape here and change the color. So now if I want to use the send backward command, then I don't need to move to the shape format and then click on this drop down menu. Instead I can use that command just with a single click from the quick access toolbar. So that way I can also use bring forward, or you can also add bring to front or send to back commands. So you can see that we have a lot of space for more button in this quick access toolbar. So you should add all of your favorite commands into this toolbar so you can access them just with a single click. So now we will customize the ribbon, and you can access the customize ribbon command also by right clicking on any of the tab, and here you can click on customize the ribbon, and here you can see the new tab command. Click on this, and so it automatically added a new tab and a new group, and I would like to rename this tab as drawing tools. Hit the OK key, and I also would like to rename this group, and in this group I would like to place the alignment command, so I will name it alignment. And now I will bring those commands from this drop down menu, and here I will choose all tabs and will choose the shape format tab, and here under the shape format tab I will expand this arrange option. And here we can see the bring forward, bring to front, send backward, send to back, and all alignment commands. So let's say I want to add the align center and align middle command to this alignment section of drawing tools tab. So hit the OK key, and here we have our new tab, drawing tools, and under drawing tools we have the alignment section or group. And under the alignment section we have align center and align middle commands. So let's say if I use both of these commands a lot, then I don't need to go to the shape format or find my favorite command from any other tabs, as I know that I have already added all my favorite commands to the drawing tools. So if I want to align this shape into middle and center, I can do that in just two clicks. Otherwise if you have to select the shape and go to shape format and then click on the align drop down button, and then first you have to choose align center, and then you have to choose align middle command. So you can see the difference between the mouse clicks. Like if you want to align this shape center and middle, then I can do that by going to drawing tool, align center, align middle. And before ending this lesson, let's move back to the file options. And if you want to save all types of customization in quick access toolbar and in the ribbon, then you can also export your settings as a file. So you can click this option, export all customization, and let's say I save it on desktop, PowerPoint customizations 2. And later if you, let's say, reinstall Microsoft Office or someone reset the all types of customization or you reset them by yourself, then you can later import all of those settings from that file which you exported earlier. So as you can see that we have reset the ribbon and the quick access toolbar, and now I again move to more commands, and here again I click on this drop down button import export, and this time I choose import customization file, import customization file, and move to desktop and choose this file and click open and hit yes and hit OK, and there you again have the tab and the customization in quick access toolbar. So if you often need to access a lot of commands from different tabs, then you can create your own new tab and can add all of your favorite commands into a single tab. That way it will save you a lot of time in routine. So I hope you will find this video informative and interesting. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video. And you can also subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos.